I was no one. I came from Pottstown, Pennsylvania, the most random, tiny, rural city, and now I'm here. So imagine you not only have been bullied since the sixth grade, but now the rest of the world is looking at you too, and they're pointing out everything that's wrong with you.
We are in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. Population 22,000, right? I don't think that's not a lot of people for a town, is it?
Before Lauren could even walk, Lauren knew what song she liked. She would put on little concerts.
She'd go, I don't know, it was a dollar store or somewhere. She picked up like a roll of tickets.
She would act like she was selling everybody tickets to her show.
And whenever there wasn't enough people, she'd put stuffed animals and things out.
I've been on social media since I was 13. So I downloaded Musical.ly.
Musical.ly was like, you know, the lip syncing app, and kids would do videos.
We all made them together. Like, it was the thing to do.
At first, it was just me being silly, doing covers, and I loved doing it because I was 100% myself. I would choreograph dance routines and make my friends be my backup dancers.
I don't think I really realized the power of it when she first got into it.
I was at a sleepover. We were getting ready for bed, and they were like, Lauren, you have like 30,000 followers.
And I was like, oh, okay.
Let's make another one tomorrow.
So then I downloaded the app. So I'm like trying to watch her and keep an eye on it.
I saw the following starting to grow.
50,000, 100,000, 200,000. And I mean, it just like kept going up.
People would post reaction videos and compilations. My videos were getting featured one after the other after the other.
We got to that level when it was like millions of people. At that point, no matter where you go, someone's going to recognize her eventually. It was pretty clear that she wasn't just going to be a normal kid now. All the other kids' social media platforms weren't taking off like Lauren's were.
The kids that were doing Musical.ly, that had a good following, all of a sudden pulled off of it. And then they started making fun of it.
Our best friends at the time turned against her.
Then they started bullying her online.
And they would write awful things, that I have no talent, that I'm rude, that I have lip fillers, that I've had work done, I was albino, I was anorexic. People were saying they were gonna jump me, to the point where I was in the school bathroom calling my mom, telling her I was scared.
Sorry. It's bad when you see your child not wanna go to school. That's where it hurts me, because kids don't know what they do to these kids when they're bullying them like that. Because I literally watched my kid cry for 24 hours. I put her in counseling, took her out of school.
I didn't leave the house a lot. And it was just really lonely. So this is where my videos were made.
I think a lot of social media kids, you'll see that they're not comfortable in their environment. They're comfortable in front of a camera, though.
Oh, shoot, I'm recording. What's up, you guys? It's Lauren. Making videos, that was my outlet. Then I bought all this lighting and cameras and equipment, and I was always singing. I would go to my music lessons.
Music's been a huge part of her life from the very beginning.
I posted a few videos of myself singing here and there. You get comments like, oh, she has no talent, like she's just pretty. I can only explain so much. People, no, I have been playing piano. No, I have been playing the guitar. I have been singing.
They put you in a box and they're like, okay, you just stay doing your Musical.ly videos and that's where you belong.
I let myself get put in that box.
Through the years, I've seen her become a little more guarded.
Even like talking and things like this, in my head, I'm so worried about how my personality is coming across. It's a lot of pressure, especially with having such a big following. I've just been trying to get out of that headspace.
She was like, I don't want them to see me like that. I don't want them to see that, you know, I'm letting that get to me.
I love you guys, and I will see you soon. Bye.
On the social media tours, they'll play like games, or they'll do like little surveys with the crowd.
We're trying to decide what she was gonna do.
And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna sing.
Oh, what? I was like, no, 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 no.
I'm having a heart attack because this is the first time I've ever seen her sing live in front of all these people. Kid walks up with a microphone, is like, Lauren, you're up. She's like, okay, walks right out, lights come on.
Finally, I kind of started to see that I had fans who were there and who love me and who want to see me do well. And I realized I need to trust myself and start telling myself that I have what it takes.
Her manager at the time, he was like, do you know how huge this kid's gonna be? I was like, man, I'm starting to get the idea.
I was already in the studio before that tour, writing and recording music, and I had quite a few songs that were already finished.
So she was like, if I'm gonna take this seriously, then I need people who are ingrained into the music industry to back me and believe in me. And then thankfully, she had meetings with Capitol.
They just sat her down and said, so where do you envision yourself? Lauren said, I want to sell out arenas. Deadpan.
Now that she has Capitol behind her, she's buckled down even more so.
Today is special because I'm doing my meet and greet with Forever 21.
So great to see all your faces in person.
To be honest, when I'm in front of them, I don't get scared because I feel like they know me so well. I read every single letter because my fans lifted me out of this awful, awful time. They give me the platform to use my voice, and I encourage them to say nice things to each other.
Nice to meet you, you're so pretty, I love your hair.
Thank you, I love you so much.
I love you.
The more engaged you are and the more positive you are towards them, the more likely they are to take that love that they feel and bring it somewhere else.
In middle school, I had like the toughest time and you got me like so much through it.
Okay, so wait, what are we doing? What's going on right now?
So we're gonna walk into the middle of the median and we're gonna see the billboard.
Okay.
What's happening for her right now? I think it's like every parent's dream.
It's kind of like you have to make your decision. Am I gonna pursue what I really wanna do and not worry about what other people think?
That's so badass! I'm gonna cry, guys. That's so awesome. I graduated.
I have a freaking billboard in Times Square, which is like crazy. All I could think of was, imagine if I had listened to what people said.
She never gave up. She just keeps doing her thing. It's amazing to watch.